أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Another major signs of the sign of the signs of the hour is Yajuj wa Majuj. But before we explore this sign, we need to be reminded of the methodology of addressing such matters of unseen, that we restrict ourselves to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that we keep away from weak transmitted narrations that have no basis, nor we try to look for details. You will notice if you address this subject or try to explore this subject, you will find a lot of people coming up with a lot of unnecessary details. We don't do that. We just try to understand it the way that corresponds to our adherence to the way of our righteous predecessors, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. The fact that Ya'juj and Ma'juj, being a sign of the hour, and actually one of the major signs of the hour, was established in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, qawlullahi ta'ala, hatta idha futihat Ya'juj wa Ma'juj wa hum min kulli hadabin yansilun waqtaraba al-wa'd al-haq. Until Ya'juj and Ma'juj, other people pronounce it Gog and Magog, but we will stick to the Arabic version of it, because those two tribes are very well known to even followers of the religions before us. They do actually have their stories in the Old Testament, and they are aware of them. So they would call them Gog and Magog, but the Quran named them Ya'juj wa Ma'juj, so we would rather stick to that, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this verse, in Surah Al-Anbiya, حَتَّى إِذَا فُتِحَتْ يَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ وَهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ حَدَبٍ يَنْسِلُونَ. Until Ya'juj and Ma'juj are let loose, that tells you that they are somehow detained somewhere, that they are imprisoned somewhere, because let loose meaning that they will break out somehow. They will pour down or swarm, I guess that's another word, another verb, from every elevated or mounted place, or from every direction. وَهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ حَدَبٍ يَنْسِلُونَ. Look at this. وَاقْتَرَبَ الْوَعْدُ الْحَقِّ. And the true promise shall draw near of fulfillment, talking about the hour. In the Sunnah hadith, Hudayfa ibn Asid al-Ghifari, radiyallahu anhu, the famous hadith which compiled the 10 signs of the hour, the 10 major signs of the hour. Hudhayfa says, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one day he entered into the masjid and he found us studying or discussing a matter of the religion. فَقَالَ, he said to us, مَا تَذَاكَرُونَ, what are you discussing? قَالُوا نَتَذَاكَرُ السَّاعَةَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, they said, we are discussing the hour, O Messenger of Allah. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إِنَّهَا لَنْ تَأْتِي حَتَّى تَرَوْنَ قَبْلَهَا عَشْرَ آيَاتٍ, it will not come until you see before it 10 signs. The scholars, they say, these are the 10 major signs. وَذَكَرْ يَأْجُوج وَمَأْجُوج, one of the 10 signs, he named يَأْجُوج وَمَأْجُوج. طيب, who are يَأْجُوج and مَأْجُوج? Like I mentioned, those are two names of two tribes who lived a long time ago. We really don't know exactly, like I said, we don't speculate with matters of unseen. We don't make up stuff. We don't know exactly when they lived. 1,000 years ago, during the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam, during the time of Musa alayhi salam, we don't know. But they existed a long time ago because the books of the previous religions have accounts of them. So that means they existed before them. Also, we do have our mention of them in the Quran and the Sunnah, and I shared with you the evidences, at least, which show that they are a major sign of the Day of Judgment. The words Ya'juj and Ma'juj are two names for a non-Arab thing. Ismani A'jamiyan. They are not Arabic names. So Ya'juj and Ma'juj are not Arabic names. They are names of what? Non-Arab stuff. They say that they are derived. So these names are derived. Some suggested that they are derived from Al-Ma'j. Al-Ma'j, when you, like the waves of the sea, how they go with one another. Ma'j. They are really referring to the verse in Surah Al-Kahf, وَتَرَكْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَمُوجُ فِي بَعْضٍ. After the Qarnayn detained them behind the wall, Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we left them surging against one another like the waves of the sea. So Ya'juj min al-Ma'j, that's an Arabic word. وَقِيلَ يَأْجُوج مِنَ الْأَجِيج, when the fire gets heated so much, it makes Ajij. Because later on we will understand that Ya'juj and Ma'juj will be the majority of the dwellers of hell. And we're going to come to this. طيب, الشاهد يا إخوة, here is what you need to believe in regarding Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Number one, they are two tribes from the offspring of Adam and Eve, both Adam and Hawa. Because if you open the books, there are stories out there that they come only from Adam. And I will share the story with you. And this is why, ya ikhwa, we stick to the authentically transmitted accounts in our religion, especially in matters of unseen, because we have not seen it. I will share with you a story which is fabricated, and if you open the books, actually you will find that story out there, and you will find renowned scholars somehow indirectly adopting it. They actually, like Sakhawi, for example, is a famous scholar of the Ummah. he adopted it. He didn't say the same version, but he made a statement which shows his approval of the story. What is the story? That Adam, alayhi salam, one day was asleep. He had a wet dream. So his mani, his sperm, got mixed with the dirt. And from there, Yajuj and Majuj came. That's a story out there. Out, you will find it. And they attribute it to Ka'b al-Ahbar, one of the Jewish rabbis, Ka'b ibn Mati' al-Himyari, who accepted Islam at the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. That is why, ya ikhwa, the first element regarding believing in that sign, that you must believe that they come from Adam and Hawa, both. They are from the offspring of Adam. This is number one. Number two, بدليل السنة, in the day of judgment, and I will share the hadith with you later on, inshallah, hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, radiallahu anhu, in the day of resurrection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam, in front of humanity, and he will say to him, Ya Adam, O Adam, أخرج بعث النار من ذريتك. Take out the delegation of fire, the dwellers of fire, from your offspring. And if you go through the hadith, you're going to find out that Ya'juj and Ma'juj are mentioned. Inshallah, we will come to refuting, even though the hadith does not say Eve, but it's a sign that they are human beings. Because the other way is really shows that they are not human. They are somehow, it's a very interesting way. But we'll come to refuting that story, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. The second thing, they are disbelievers. They are not believers. None of them is a mu'min. They are all disbelievers. Number three, they used to spread corruption in earth. Inna Ya'juj wa Ma'juj mufsiduna fil ard. So, and when they break, or when they are let loose by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will go back to corrupting earth again, as we will find out, and this will happen in the future. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is number what? Four. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a righteous king called Dhul Qarnayn the power to detain them behind a barrier, a sad, a radm, a wall. And we're going to come to the story, inshallah. As we speak right now, these are the, if you want to come up with elements or components of your belief in this major sign, these are the things that you must believe in without any shadow of that, of doubt, without any doubt. This is what you're supposed to believe. Number five, as we speak right now, every single day, they try to simply pierce or dig through that wall. And they do somehow succeed. But when they leave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fills that hole again and makes it stronger than the way that they dug it before. Until one day when Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is in earth, and he has killed the Antichrist, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ordain for them to break through. And this will happen in the future. And this is what is meant by حَتَّى إِذَا فُتِحَتْ يَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ, until Ya'juj and Ma'juj are let loose from behind the wall which they are kept or detained behind as we speak right now. And this is a sign of the hour. Number what? Six. لا يدان لأحد بقتالهم. They are extremely strong people. Very strong. Imagine after Prophet Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام في حديث النواس ابن سمعان رضي الله عنه عند مسلم, after he kills the Antichrist and he goes to comfort the believers who were fighting with the Imam al-Mahdi for all these years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals or will reveal to Prophet Isa alayhi salam, Ya Isa, O Isa, inni adhantu li'ibadilli, I have decreed for Yajuj and Majuj, the reference here is to Yajuj and Majuj, is to break through that wall. Look, لا يدان لأحد بقتالهم. No one can fight them. No power can stop them. فحرز عبادي بجبل الطور. Take the believers and seek shelter in a mountain called الطور. Whether it is in Sinai, whether it is in Palestine, there are two of them as we speak. But somehow, here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that no one can fight them whatsoever. Number? Seven. They multiply in a way that is out of this world. شوف, حتى إذا فتحت, until they are let loose, يأجوج ومأجوج, look at this, وهم, they will, من كل حدب ينسلون, they will pour down. The word pour down is used with rain. There is an author which is weak, not strong, that says each one of them will not die until he sees 1,000 kids, offspring. Imagine this. And also hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu an is an evidence, is a point of reference to this as well. Why? لأن Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to Adam alayhi salam, O Adam, take out from your offspring the delegation of fire. Simply the people from your offspring who will go to where? Jahannam. Adam will seek further explanation. وَمَا بَعْثُ النَّارِ. After he says لَبَّيْكَ وَسَعْدَيْكَ, showing respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will do it ya Rabb, but what do you mean by مَا بَعْثُ النَّارِ؟ قَالَ, he said, مِنْ كُلِّ أَلْفْ, out of each 1,000, 999 to go to hell. The Sahaba, the companions, when they heard this, they immediately said, who's going to be that one person? Basically, the salvation is what? The ratio is what? One what? 1%. Who's going to be that 1%? Imagine this. Who's going to be that one person? 0.1%. Less than that. Not even a 1%, right? 0.01, right? Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, relax. Out of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, 999, and from you, one person. So can somebody do the math now? You're getting it. So originally, from every human, every 1,000 human originally, everybody now, how many? 999 will go to hell. And one person will go where? To Jannah. Now the Prophet ﷺ came back and he said what? Don't worry. Let's do another math now. That 999 from those 999, correct? and one from you. 998, I think the hadith reads 999 from Yajuj and Majuj. Basically, almost those 999 from Yajuj and Majuj, and very few from the rest of the human. Let's keep it simple. Let's not go into math. So that shows you that their numbers are what? Huge numbers. So they multiply. Tayyib, what number are we still after here? It was said that they live long life. They get to live a long life. We have some accounts that their faces كالمجان المطرقة like flatted faces. Now, if I tell you they look like what? Chinese. But now some people will say what? Then they are the Ya'juj and Ma'juj. That is wrong because we don't know where Ya'juj and Ma'juj are. You see, maybe the Chinese or the Turks or the Mughal, that's their looking. That's how they look. Their faces are flattened, wide, and their eyes are what? Small. So this is the description of who? The people who live in North China, Northern China, and the Mughal, a place in Mongolia, in Asia. But now some of you will say, well, then the Chinese are Ya'juj and Ma'juj. La. What do you mean? Ya'juj and Ma'juj are behind what? It is okay that Chinese look like them. ولذلك ورد في the scholars when they explain the word Turk. Because there are people who say that they look like a Turk. They say why they are called Turk. A Turk derived from a Turk, leaving, that they were left and they were not placed behind the wall. They were what? Matrukin, yani. A Turk derived from what? Yani Allah left for us some people who look like them. You're getting it? This is overall what we believe in, ya ikhwa, regarding Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Tayyib, let's come to the that story which the people refer to always. You will find that Imam Muslim actually compiled it when he explained Sahih Muslim, fil Nawawi. Afwan, Imam Nawawi, when he explained Sahih Muslim, he mentioned the story. Like I mentioned also, someone like Sakhawi adopted it. I shared with you the story already that they say that when Adam was asleep, he had a wet dream that sperm got mixed up with the dirt, and from there Ya'juj and Ma'juj, they came out. طبعاً هذه القصة, this story doesn't simply validate itself using intellect, عقلاً ولا نقلاً, nor using text. Number one, the story is weak. قالوا, they said it is one of the lies which are attributed to Ka'b al-Ahbar. That Ka'b al-Ahbar himself never said that. But the people made up the story and they said Ka'b is the one who said it, who made it up. Ka'b is innocent. Ka'b, ya ikhwa, is a Jewish rabbi who was known of his knowledge. Yemeni, from Yemen. His name is Ka'b ibn Mata' al-Himyari. He used to live in Yemen. He accepted Islam at the time of Umar. Remember, we normally narrate the hadith that a Jewish rabbi came to Umar and he said, there is a verse in your Quran, if it was revealed upon us Jews. You ever heard me or heard somebody narrating that hadith? That there is a verse in your Quran, if it was revealed upon us Jews, it would have, hadith Tariq ibn Shihab in Bukhari, would have taken the day on which this verse was revealed, the day of Eid. Then Umar asked him, what verse? Al-Yawma, today, Akmaltu lakum deenakum. Today I completed the deen for you. You know who is that Jewish rabbi? Ka'b. Ka'b al-Ahbar. Ka'b ibn Namat. So he was known of his righteousness and piety and his taqwa and his knowledge. He had extensive knowledge. That's why they called him Ka'b. Ka'b. Al-Ahbar. Mish Habr Wahid. Al-Ahbar is the plural of what? Rabbi. Ka'b. The rabbis. He's rabbis. Not just one rabbi. Ka'b al-Ahbar. Al-Ahbar is the plural of Habr. Huh? So he is what? He's a lot of Ahbar. He's a lot of Habr in one person. First of all, there is no evidence that validate the story. في القرآن ولا في السنة ما فيش دليل عليها. Always, يا إخوة, if there is no evidence, I know that the description of those people are weird. Is weird. يعني if you really explore their description. They're going to come out, they're going to drink all the water, and if we go over the ahadith, they are weird. They are not like warad mufsiduna fil ard. Mujahid or muqatil, I believe, he said, yufsiduna fil ard, mufsiduna, ya'juj wa ma'juj mufsiduna fil ard, ya'juj and ma'juj are corrupting in earth. He said, ya'kuluna an-nas, they eat people. But this does not give you the legitimacy to come up with a story to prove that their creation is what? is not from, because they are human. They are human being. They are human beings. Like, you know, a lot of the people, they come in and say, you know, Maryam got pregnant. She conceived, right? Some people, they come and say, but her pregnancy was only one night. Why? Because how she conceived? Through what? Through an angel. Jibreel alayhi salam, he blown in her sleeves and the process. So now because of that pregnancy, a lot of the people said what? But her pregnancy was not 9 months. Do you have an evidence for that? As long as you do not have an evidence, then we go back to the what? الأصل. ما هو يقول لك إيه؟ If there is no evidence to take the case from الأصل, from the default, to a new scenario, then we have to retreat to what? الأصل. We have to go back to الأصل. Likewise, yeah, their creation is weird. The fact that they are detained somewhere in earth and nobody knows about them, this is weird. We believe it. But this does not legitimize or validate a false story. If there is no evidence from the Quran, nor the Sunnah, then we go back to what? Al-Asl. Al-Asl what? They are human beings. Al-Aql, using intellect, if this is the way that they were created, that gives them what? That gives them a status. That makes them like who? Like Hawa. It makes them like Isa. Because look at the miraculous creation of Allah. Adam was created from what? No father, no mother. Hawa, father without a mother. Isa, from a mother without a father. Me and you, father and mother. Now, if they were created according to that process, that makes them what? Like who? Like Hawa. صحيح ولا لا? That would give them a status. لا. العقل يرفض هذه القصة. يا إخوة, Prophet Adam, Prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam had 4 children. Here is their names: Ham, Sam, Yafith, Kanaan. According to the Quran, in Surah Hud, one of them what? Drowned. ف فحال بينهما الموج فكان من المغرقين. كنعان drowned. He did not believe and he drowned. He did not get on the ship. Who stayed? Ham is the father of the Sudanese, meaning the people with the black skin. Sam is the father of the Arabs and the Jews. Yafith is the father of the Turk. So they say that Yajuj and Majuj come from who? Yafith. Because all of us, by the way, that's why they call Prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam the second father of humanity. Who is the father of humanity? Adam. But what happened? People lived for 1,000 years. No shirk بين Adam and Nuh. 100 عام. 10 قرون. I'm sorry. 100 years. 10 centuries. كلهم على التوحيد. All of them were on Tawheed. Until they started worshipping idols. وَدَّنْ سُوَاعًا يَغُوثْ يَعُوقْ وَنَسْرًا. 5 idols. Prophet Nuh came to invite them to monotheism, to Tawheed again. They rejected his message. Allah said to Nuh, get the believers on a ship. And earth what? Flooded. So whoever stayed on the ship with Nuh made humanity. صحيح يا إخوة؟ طيب. How they look like also, like the people made up stories, you know, regarding their origin. Also they made up stories regarding their appearance, their shape. يعني, also they attributed to Ka'b that they are 3 types. One type as huge as a tree in Lebanon called al-Aruz. Shajar al-Aruz, huge tree. It's like, some said that they are 4 by 4. 4 arm length by 4 arm length. They made up these stories, by the way. And they attributed them again to Ka'b. They said Ka'b said that. Another thing they said that they would sleep on one ear. So one ear would be a bed and the other ear would be the blanket. Again, but there is nothing. These are made up what? Maho, listen, the whole story is what? Is sci-fi, basically. Okay, that's what we come up with. It's sci-fi. But we're very disciplined. We only approve, transmitted what? Nothing. Nothing is established. They also mentioned Athar. Another author to Ibn Abbas, they attributed the statement to Abdullah ibn Abbas, but the scholars of hadith have weakened the author. So some of you may say, why are you mentioning it, Sheikh? Because the people may assume that I don't know about it. Whoever sees this, or you're hearing me, and you probably came across that author, and here I am giving you the description according to what's in the Quran, what's in the Sunnah, and then, oh, the Sheikh maybe have not heard about Athar Abdullah ibn Abbas. I'm telling you that I heard about it, and it is weak. It is not strong, it's weak. You're getting it, and that's why, ya ikhwa, sometimes you may have to narrate what? The weak accounts, not to show that you believe in it, but to let the people know that I'm aware of it, and it is weak. Correct? Because if you ignore it, they may think that you did not come across it. Nobody can compile the what? You're going to miss something, some place, somewhere. Yani nobody is going to be able to compile all the knowledge of something. The people may assume that you don't know about it. Athar ibn Abbas, what he says? He said there are three types. There are three types also. Sinfun shibr. One type is one shibr. What is a shibr? Anybody knows a shibr? Huh? Inch. They look an inch. وَصِنْفٌ شِبْرَان 2 inches, 3 inches. And they have nails and their hair is like their clothes. Again, أَثَرْوَا here. القول الثالث, the third opinion, is القول الراجح. They are human beings like you and me. From the offspring of Yafith, they have strength, because the hadith, the Prophet said to Prophet Isa, what? Nobody can what? Can fight them. So they have strength. They are plenty in numbers. Uwarat, it was authentically transmitted in Mu'jam al-Tabarani, Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, that their faces are flattened, wide, their eyes are small. We stick to that, and that's it. We leave it at this, بإذن الله تعالى. طيب. ورد ذكرهم في القرآن والسنة. Their mention in the Quran and the Sunnah with relation to time. So they had a story in the past. They have a story in the present as we speak. And of course, being a sign of the hour, they will have a story in the future. And subhanAllah, they do have a story in the Day of Judgment, which I refer to, Hadith Adam, which we're going to come to this. We got that? So their mention in the Quran and the Sunnah is connected with the following times: the past, the present, the future, the Day of Judgment. Today, inshallah, for the sake of time, let's deal with the first two: the past and the present. We'll leave the future, which really gonna get us to when they break from behind that wall, when they are let loose, what will they do, and how they will perish, and so forth. And the future, will share with you Hadith Abi Sa'id in details, and get the understanding of this hadith, and maybe we'll figure out these numbers, which we're unable to figure out today. But the past was mentioned في سورة الكهف. The story of a righteous king called Dhulqarnain. One of the stories mentioned, which the disbelievers in Mecca questioned the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about it. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. They ask you about ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. Simply, if you go and explore Ibn Kathir at the very beginning of Surah Al-Kahf, you will find out the reason for the revelation of Surah Al-Kahf to begin with. That at one stage, the disbelievers in Mecca suggested that let's prove that the Prophet ﷺ is illegitimate by proving that he does not receive revelation. Who can help us? The people who are aware of the book in Medina, the Jews. They sent a delegation of three to Medina, and they went and met with the Jews. They said, we have this man in our town who claims to be a prophet. Can he help us out? So the Jews said to the delegation, ask him about three things. If he answers you, then he is a prophet. No one knows this but a prophet. And if he doesn't, then you know what to do. Ask him about a group of youth. They had a fascinating, amazing story. They existed a while back. They mean what? Fityatul ايه? Al-Kahf. and ask him about Dhil Qarnayn. They didn't say Dhil Qarnayn, by the way. وَاسْأَلُوهُ عَنْ رَجُلٍ طَوَّافٍ. Ask him about a man who traveled earth. And the third question, ask him about الروح. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ الروح. The answer to their question came in Surah Al-Kahf, and in it came the mention of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. They say, Ya Ikhwah, there are four people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given them the reign over all of earth. Malakul Ard. They became kings over what? Earth. Two are righteous and two are wicked. The two who are righteous is Sulaiman عليه الصلاة والسلام and ذي القرنين. The two who are wicked are النمرود, the one who debated with Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, and the one who destroyed the kingdom of Bani Israel called Buktunassar, I believe. Buktunassar, that's the name. No, Buktunassar or something, I think he has a... Buktunassar, that's his name. The one who destroyed the Mamlakat al-Yahud, Bani Israel. And the fifth one will be righteous, which will be who? Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Prophet Isa will rule over earth. Fadil Qarnayn was a righteous king. But again, we do not know when he lived, where did he come from. But there is a suggestion that he is Yemeni. Because the kings of Yemen, Yemen used to be some sort of a superpower. They used to use the term Dhu. Dhu. Dhu something. Dhu means the possessor of. So their kings used to associate the word Dhu with their names. It's like Dhu something. Al-Qarnayn, by the way, does not mean that is not his name. Al-Qarnayn, they say, is a description. And they suggested that he was called Dhul Qarnayn because of two reasons. Reason number one, he traveled to the far east and the far west. So the two ends of earth. Or he used to wear, what do you call that? A helmet. And it had two horns on the top of it. These are the suggestions. But the Shahid, the Quran mentions that this man was a righteous man. He's a righteous king whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empowered in earth. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. They ask you about ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. قُلْ سَأَتْلُوا عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا. I will give you a brief mention of him. إِنَّا مَكَّنَّا لَهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. We empowered him in earth. You see, ikhwan, no one gets empowered unless what? Allah what? Allah wills. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ سَبَبًا. And we've given him the means. You see, he did two things. He utilized the means, one, to the bringing people to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هذا يا إخوة هو يعني that Allah الذين إن مكناهم في الأرض, those when we empower in earth, what they do? أقاموا الصلاة, آتوا الزكاة, أمروا بالمعروف, نهوا عن المنكر. Unfortunately, a lot of people get empowered in earth now, get empowered in earth through money, through power, and they use this to do what? To corrupt earth. Imagine a Muslim, Allah gives wealth, Wealth is empowerment. Huh? And he goes and he opens a liquor store. Or he opens a marijuana dispensary in Denver. And he looks for a sheikh to give him a ruling. And he hates the sheikh if the sheikh says it's haram. This is empowerment. That Allah gives you means, but you use these means to fight what? Huh? Look, when Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah giving him all these armies. وَحُشِرَ لَهُ جُنُودُهُ وَحُشِرَ لِسُلَيْمَانَ جُنُودُهُ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ وَالطَّيْرِ فَهُمْ jinn, ins and birds. Look, when he missed the hudhud, huh? What happened? Where is the hudhud? The hudhud knew that Sulaiman cares about tawheed. He came back with confidence, even though he heard the threats that he will be slayed for missing the being there when he was checking on you. He said, "Jitukum min saba'in binaba'in yaqeen." I'm sorry, I have a reason for my absence, and I know this is of interest to you. إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم وأوتيت من كل شيء ولها عرش عظيم وجدتها وقومها يسجدون للشمس من دون الله. I found people worshiping the sun. Immediately, Sulaiman used all the resources to bring what? The woman, the queen of Sheba, and her people to Islam. هكذا. Dhul Qarnayn likewise. Look, the first stop, for the sake of time, hatta idha balagha maghrib ash-shams, until he reached the setting place of the sun. Now, where the sun sets, where is maghrib ash-shams? Wajadaha taghrubu fi aynin hamia. He found the sun setting in a spring of black muddy water. Does the sun set in a black muddy water? No, what is meant that he traveled to the west, that's where the sun sets, and earth ended, and he saw an ocean, and he saw the sun sitting where? In the ocean. Basically, he reached the west side of earth. And we know that there is the Atlantic, right? The Atlantic Ocean. America was not discovered yet. America is only 300 years ago. Could be the Indian Ocean too, yeah. But in any rate, a place in the West, and he saw the sun setting there. And he found people living there. Allah said to him, "Imma an tu'adhiba," some of them are righteous and some of them are wicked. Either you punish them, the wicked, or either you treat them with kindness. Look at his manhaj now. "Amma man zalam," those who wrong, we will punish them. Beside their punishment, where? ثم يرد إلى ربه فيعذبه عذابا نكرا. Just to show you his righteousness and piety, that's the manhaj. For you to stop corruption, you have to, show forth, strength, especially if you are empowered. ولذلك يا إخوة, when الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke about enjoining good and forbidding evil, what is the first tool? Is what? The hand. Who should use the hand? The sultan. The leader. If the leader doesn't use the hand, who's going to use the hand? Who's going to use it? Me and you? So we get beaten up by the people? ولذلك عثمان بن عفان says, إن الله يزع بالسلطان ما لا يزع بالقرآن. Allah stops evil through what? Sultan. More than what? can be stopped through the Quran, through the revelation, that you go to somebody, haram alik, ittaqillah, astaghfirullah, oh, this is haram. The people, but when he knows that if you do this, Umar, imagine, when you do this, Umar is out there for you. Fawab will listen, I'm a leader. I have to stop corruption on earth. I have to enjoin good. I'm not going to treat them kindly, no. I have to establish the criminal punishment, the had against them for their violations. And guess what? That is not only the violation, the punishment they will receive. And when they go back to Allah, when they will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will receive another punishment. I'll look at this. And those who are righteous and pious, we will speak kindly and softly to them. We'll bring them near to us. And guess what? When they go back to Allah, they will receive much better reward. شوف يا إخوة, a sign of righteousness and piety of leaders, when they bring near them who? The righteous and the pious. And they speak kindly to them. But what is happening now? Look at the leaders. Who's surrounding them? Bunch of mafia people. Corrupt. All the corrupt people are around the leaders. But the righteous and the pious are what? Pushed away. They hardly remembered. ثم أتبع سببا. Then he traveled another place. This time he traveled where the sun rises. The rising place of the sun. حتى إذا بلغ مطلع الشمس. Now, he found people out there who do not have what? A shield against the sun. That tells you where is that place. Where? What east? You know the places where there is no light? There is no night? The north side. They have no shield from the sun. What shield you and me from the sun is what? The night time, the dark. But the people who live in that side, their day and night is what? 24 hours. Their day is what? 24 hours. So they don't have no shield against what? So he must have traveled all the way to what? To the north. Now, the Quran didn't say what did he do. But Allah said that he managed the situation. He basically taught them how to build what? Caves and stuff like that so they can protect themselves from the sun sometime during the 24 hours. We come to our group here. حتى إذا بلغ بين السدين. He reached a place where there are two mountains. وجد عندها قوما لا ي... وجد من دونهما قوما لا يكادون يفقهون قولا. He found people living there. Really, a lot of the scholars, they say the meaning of the, they do not comprehend that their intellect is not what? They are not smart. He can tell that they are not smart. When they saw him immediately, they said, يَا ذَا الْقَرْنَيْنِ إِنَّ يَأْجُوجَ وَمَأْجُوجَ مُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. We have those two corrupt tribes. Ibn al-Jawzi compiled four meanings of مُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Number one, they do the act of Qawm Lut, the people of Lut, which is what? Homosexuality. عطاء الخرساني said they kill people. مقاتل, so I mistakenly spoke, I said مجاهد, he's مقاتل ابن سليمان. He said that they eat people. Previously I said مجاهد, it's مقاتل, not مجاهد. They eat people. And the fourth opinion is the authentic one, that they would come back, they would come out when the people are harvesting. You know, they grow their crops, and when they harvest, they come and take the harvest away and they leave. You know, there is a picture that came a long time, an old called the Magnificent Seven. Huh? Likewise, if you came across that picture called the Magnificent Seven, that people, they wait for the farmers to harvest their thing, and they come and they take it out. Now listen, we'll give you a pay, we'll give you kharj, we'll give you something, if you can block So simply they used to live near two mountains, and they used to come from behind these two mountains through an entry. He said, if you can help us, we'll pay you. If you can help us, what? Block that entry. He said, listen, I do not need your money. مَا مَكَّنِّي فِيهِ رَبِّ خَيْرٌ. But I'm not going to work for you here. You're going to work. Now what I want you to do is go and bring me blocks of iron. Fill that hole until it reached what? It was filled completely between the two mountains. They piled it up until it filled up the gap between the two mountains. Then he said, put it on fire. And he brought molten, that's the top line of engineering, they tell you that. He brought molten copper, right? Nuhas al-Mudab. And he poured it on the top of it. فَمَسْطَاعُوا أَنْ يَظْهَرُوا. Now the molten copper made it what? Slippery. You cannot what? Climb. وَمَسْتَطَاعُوا لَهُ نَقْبًا. They could not pierce or dig through it. And they're behind that wall right now. So subhanAllah, Ikhwa Dhul Qarnayn just showing them, because he saw them being delighted and happy about it. He said, listen, قال هذا رحمة من ربي. What happens from Allah's mercy, that Allah now prevented them from coming and corrupting and taking away your wealth. But don't live thinking that this will always be the case. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعْدُ رَبِّي. There is a promise for that wall to break out, to break down, to be level to the ground. جَعَلَهُ دَكَّاء. One day that wall will be level to the ground. وَكَانَ وَعْدُ رَبِّي حَقَّاء. So this is, ya ikhwa, their mention in the past. In the present, in one page inshallah, so we pray Isha. ورد في حديث النواس بن سمعان الكلابي وحديث أبي هريرة في سنن الترمذي صححه الشيخ الألباني رحمه الله حديث النواس في صحيح الإمام مسلم that every single day as we speak, and this is the present, they go and try to dig through that wall. And they do actually manage to dig in Hadith al-Nawas until they actually see the rays of the sun in the other side. Their head or their leader or their Amir will say, we're getting tired today, let's come back tomorrow. They would come back tomorrow and they will find that hole filled again and restored as if it was not touched before. Until, and this is in the future, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, when Prophet Isa alayhi salam is in earth, and after he killed the Antichrist, their leader will say, let's come back tomorrow, and he will say what? Insha'Allah. Even though he's not a Muslim, but subhanallah, insha'Allah would help him. They will come back the following day. They will find the hole the way they left it. They will carry on digging through it. And they will break through that wall. And this is what we'll find out next lecture, inshallah. What will they do, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And we'll address also hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, inshallah, in the next lecture. There is, in closing, inshallah, there is a shahid of this hadith. There is a point of reference in another hadith to this. Hadith Zainab bint Jahsh, radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, the mother of the believers. Her name is Zainab bint Jahsh. One day, the hadith fil Bukhari wa Muslim, agreed upon actually the hadith fil Bukhari wa Muslim. She said, one day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke from his sleep, his face is red, and he was very disturbed. And he started saying, La ilaha illallah, waylun lil Arab min sharrin qad iqtarab. Woe to the Arabs from an evil that is about to happen to them. Futiha al-yawma, today, the wall which Dhul Qarnayn established was dug, and he did like this. Futiha al-yawma, this much. They managed to open that much. Min radmi Ya'juj wa Ma'juj. And he did his circle like this, with his finger and the index, like this. Zainab asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, anahlaku wa fina as-salihun. Can we perish? Can we be destroyed when we have righteous people living amongst us? Qala na'am. He said, yes. Idha kathura al-khabath. When evil spreads. How come these righteous and pious are not what? Are not enjoying good and forbidding evil. So inshallah, next lecture, bi-idhni Allahi ta'ala, we will finish the sign as we talk about what will they do when they break through the wall, when Prophet Isa and the believers are being shielded and protected or seeking shelter in that mountain called the Tur, and how they will perish, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will finish them off. And also inshallah, we will explain hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri fi Sahih al-Bukhari regarding them being the majority of the dwellers of hell. Jazakumullahu khaira. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.